Birmingham, which became the workshop of the world during Industrial Revolution. Yet it was located far from sources of principal raw material, especially copper and zinc, on which most of its manufacture relied upon. Transport was a problem, since it was also a good distance from any port. How, under these circumstances, did Birmingham manage to attract such a disproportionate share of Great Britain's outstanding entrepreneurs, investors, and skilled artisans? Why it became Great Britain's leading center for all kind of metal work, including commercial coinage? I think the answer lies in a few great people which have the vision and which drove it all the way. Matthew Boulton, born on 3rd September 1728 at Birmingham, was a great manufacturer and entrepreneur who laid down the groundwork for the Industrial Revolution. He and his partner James Watt installed hundreds of Boulton and Watt steam engines, which were the state-of-the-art technology at the time, making work efficient in factories and mills.
The Boulton's home at Soho House was placed in this area in Handsworth, partly because of its proximity to Soho Manufactory, which was the centrepiece of Boulton's working operation. And it's here that he produced a wide range of metalwares, and it was very much seen as being a very progressive and modern factory. So despite its elegant exterior, which was very much in a classical style, the quality and the fact that Boulton had employed an architect to produce the drawings and the elegant building, and the fact that Boulton had brought in this exterior help was a way of saying to people how important and how significant he felt the Soho brand should be. And it was a way of associating the goods that were produced at the manufactory as being as part of a very new and interesting and innovative way of producing those items. And one of the key things about the manufactory is that it wasn't a closed operation. It was something that members of the public and potential customers and clients could visit, and as such, Boulton himself could lead people around on factory tours. He also asked his employees to do that for him. And as part of a factory tour, there was of course an opportunity for visitors to purchase some of Boulton's fine metalware, including the Ormolu, Sheffield plate and silverware. And he laterly, from the 1770s onwards, became interested in the production of coinage. And his involvement in establishing the Soho Mint was, as I say, partly in response to his role as an employer in the centre of the city, in that he recognised that the problem with fake and counterfeit coinage was actually proving quite difficult to give accurate coins to the people that worked for him in terms of the salary and wages. And so it was actually in his own business interest to make sure that the quality of coinage would serve the purpose for which it was intended. And so Boulton looked particularly at the issue of counterfeit coinage and established a number of different and new security measures. So for example, in his production of the famous cartwheel penny, which is a very thick and heavy coin, it has an elevated ridge around the rim of the coin. And this was one of the security methods which Boulton sort of innovated. His involvement with coins was based again at Soho, at the Soho Mint in Handsworth, slightly away from the main manufactory area. And it was here that the sort of petitioning took place for securing a government contract to produce copper coinage for the country. And one of the reasons that Boulton was able to secure this contract was that his use of steam-powered technology at the Soho Mint was regarded as being particularly effective and really innovative. And it was this sort of application of the steam technology to the minting concern that enabled him to achieve success in this area. And his friend James Watt thought of Bolton's involvement in the Soho Mint, that this really should be the area for which, on his death, his legacy, if you like, should be the one thing that he's particularly renowned for.